Anthony from Chicago, what did you think of Palmer Cannon? I am reminded of him recently from a shoot that Nova did on Hannibal's YouTube channel and how he was chased away from the company by JBL. Yeah, Hannibal does some great shoot interviews. He did one recently with Duke the Dumpster Drosy that's pretty insightful. And Sid, he interviewed Sid Vicious as well. I didn't know much. When he debuted, I did not know much about Palmer Cannon. This is going back to like 2005 now, SmackDown, I think. I didn't know much about him other than when he showed up as this representative of the network. That was his gimmick. I always thought, Cyrus the Virus did it first and did it better in ECW. I never saw the guy wrestle. So I know he was a wrestler. They gave him a non-wrestling gimmick when he first debuted. So I never actually had a chance to watch him wrestle. I have no idea what kind of worker he was or anything like that. For those who don't know, Palmer Cannon was this young kid that WWE signed, and they brought him to SmackDown as a representative of, quote, the network. And he lasted maybe, what, 6 or 8 months probably before he walked out. They were overseas on an international tour, and he wa literally walked out. He flew himself home after being harassed, mercilessly harassed and bullied by JBL. And I don't think it was just JBL, just to be fair. If I remember the story, I think Chris Benoit was part of that as well. But Bradshaw apparently said and or did some really horrible things to this kid, and it just broke him. He couldn't take it anymore. And the really sad part about it, and I did not know this until I watched the part of the Nova shoot that Anthony is referring to here, because Hannibal has these clips cut up into little clips on his channel, and Nova said that, Palmer was a good kid and he had moved himself to Georgia. Like, he was really committed to this. And he moved himself to Georgia to train at Deep South. He had a brother who had just been killed around that time in a really bad motorcycle wreck. So he was going through some stuff. And he can remember getting a text message from Palmer saying, "I'm flying myself home. They got me." Or it was something to that effect. And he didn't know what that meant. And he said the one guy who literally ran out after him to try to convince him not to do this, don't fly home, don't throw your whole career away here, was Rey Mysterio. Rey felt so bad about what they did to this kid. And he told him, he said, "Look, you're one of us. You're one of us. Please don't go, stay." But Palmer had just, he broke. He'd had enough. He cracked. He was mentally checked out at that point. And a few weeks later, WWE granted him his release and he was never heard from again. I have no idea if he's even still wrestling today. I have no idea what he's doing. But yeah, those guys, JBL being among them, just harassed this guy so badly. Nova would not even repeat some of the things that were said to this kid because they were so bad. And I certainly hope it didn't involve his dead brother. Just trying to picture Ray running out after him, trying to get him not to throw his entire career away. That sucks. That really sucks. Fuck JBL.